crushing it, but the Loose and Hive are at it again. Get him out of there! Finish the job, Guardian. The throne world is in your hands. Let's keep at it. Let's get him. Dull moment, Guardian. Great work.
Hey, Guardian.
Clint says hi.
What's new?
I heard you Guardians got a lesson in sword logic today. You think you can defeat Cebu Arrath with philosophy? Right. Let me show you something. Savathun kept records, and I took a look at what she had on her sister. Got a recording from way back, just after you Guardians drop-kicked Oryx into Saturn's orbit. Call it a primary source for your little research project.
Our brother is dead. I will take my revenge as he fought for his son.
Revenge? For what? The dead deserved to die. That's your own luck, eh? Oryx was a hypocrite, and so are you.
He loved us. He made of our deaths a study. And she, who has endured, who sharpened the sword of his defeat, has done the same. She will take up this mantle. When she is paired to her true shape, we will meet her on the bladed path.
What a vain child you are. Or it spoiled you rotten. Not everyone wants to be like you. And you won't always get your way.
I will test my strength against her brood, and she will prove our logic true.
Do you see what you Guardians did? Do you see what's happening here? Cebu Arrath thinks Eris is one of them, some kind of heir to Oryx. That ritual of hers tied a pretty bow on that theory. This is all part of Savathun's plan. But I can't help wondering, what the hell does Eris think she's doing?
Hey, Eris. Heard we have some, strange bedfellows. Though, if a bedfellow ain't strange, then they're probably not worth having.
So it seems. Have you come to urge caution? To advise against temptation?
Nah. You know what you're about. But I'm wondering, what's it like?
It begins as a feral surmise, a suspicion. I hear whispers, but they are in my voice. It rises until I am screaming. I make a demand, an atavistic fear now sublimated into a singular, desperate urge. A hunger I must endlessly sate. But the Hive are not afraid. They are awestruck. They know that I am vengeance, and they have conjured me back with vengeance.
Ooh, sounds like a wild ride.
I seek to subvert the Hive's flawed logic. I may only do so because of what I am, and what I am not. It is a wild ride.
Hey, I'll be there when you're on the other side of this.
As will I. Trust.
Thank you.
Surprise, Sunshine. Thought I'd hack this old holotech and say hello. I don't like this whole let's work together plan, but I don't have to. I've got my orders. Let me play something for you. You get all that, Guardian? Savathun wants me to give you the soft sell. But that's not really my style. So, go ahead. Bust up the throne world. Get as strong as you like. Tithe to Eris until she's fat as a tick. It's all part of Savathun's plan. Oh, you need any help digging your own grave? Just let me know.
Beloved acolyte, champion of violence, bearing tithes raw and sweet as bitten sores. A voice from the deep whispers, in your immortality, Eris Morn, may you never cease your demand for vengeance. I refuse. In time, I will destroy this hive form alongside the rest. Its power has no hold over me. Zeboroth will not fall to might alone. Every clash of blades invigorates her. Even now she feeds, as she has fed since the first red cough, the first war song. Still, I savor every tithe. Their strength thrills me, and there are so many old debts to repay. But this is not the time. The cards speak of change. A ripple is cast. A great shadow rises from the sea of blood. Something is coming.
You hear it? The thrumming of her battle song. Zeebu Aroth's brood has come.
We will make of thy sister's court a battlefield!
Drinkers, the Ammonites. We sounded their end with our blades. The Ecumene, the Harmony. They wailed in terror as we sang their extinction. Humanity has joined the chorus of our war eternal.
What is she doing? Zeebu Aroth issues her challenge.
You've really done it now. You need to chase Zeebu's goons out of here before they take over.
Guardian, press on.
Eris Morn, lead me as Hive, and send forth your brood. Have your lyres pay tribute to their god, so I may see her vengeance.
That void light will keep dragging you in if you don't contain it.
Break those void crystals to release their power.
Eris Morn, your brood arms themselves with my brother's mantle. Your acolytes pay tribute by my brother's law. Feed your worm as I feed mine. I shall test my strength against your vengeance. We will have our tithes. You drove my sister to her throne, and she found true death by your comprehension. You chased my brother to his throne, and he fell as his children by your assiduity!
And so you will fall.
Come! My court is war, and you will find me there! You prove my logic true. Meet me in blood. Match me in violence. Our brood will feed us with their tribute.
Zivu Arath, when this is finished, you will turn and run, and your worm will gnaw at you as if you were a buried corpse. You will have no tribute then, and you will starve.
This isn't over. Zivu will keep coming until she wins her war.
We need to rethink our plan. No. Our plan needs no revision. Her presence proves its efficacy. We must press on. We can't fight her.
What's new?
All right, you're here. This is serious, so listen, and listen good. Zivu Arath's forces got into the throne world. This wasn't part of the plan, but it's bad news for everybody. Savathun's been hoarding powerful creatures in those summoning pits for a long time. Partially to study, but also to keep them out of the hands of her sister. If Zivu is able to take that extra power for herself, forget it! We're all dead! You need to claim those tithes. I hate seeing it all wasted on that weirdo Eris, but it's better than the alternative. Time to get to work, hero.